With the first step done of making sure that your equipment is rated not only for the refrigerant but for flow, now we want to make sure that we're connecting it for flow. And that means following through all of the connections from the system through the recovery machine to the cylinder. As you'll see, we're going to hook up to both sides of the system using valve core removal tools to remove the Schrader. That access valve core blocks 90% of the fitting. It's a metering device that, as you'll see in our other video, will actually increase both the temperature and pressure of the cylinder during recovery and slow everything down. So before performing fast recovery, we will remove those access valve cores using a valve core removal tool. The traditional method of recovery would then connect both sides through the manifold and 3/8 hoses to the recovery machine. You can also perform direct recovery without a manifold, a method we describe in our refrigerant recovery without a manifold video. A recovery machine will only push refrigerant up to the top of its piston. That means everything from its output channel to the recovery cylinder will always have refrigerant. That means you want to make sure that the hose has the smallest volume possible without restricting the flow, such as this 3-foot 3/8 hose with 1/4-inch fittings. And then we'll want to make sure that we're connecting to the vapor port. This is the unrestricted port of the cylinder. If you're pumping in through the liquid port, you're actually going through a tube that goes to the bottom of the tank. This tube is typically a smaller diameter and greatly restricts the flow. And if you're ever hearing a knocking or rattling sound in the recovery machine, it's usually because you have a restriction somewhere on the output side that is causing the pressure inside the machine to jump around. Removing restrictions not only increases recovery speed, but also prevents some of the common headaches, such as hot tanks and loud knocking during recovery. Be sure to watch our other videos on choosing the right equipment, purging the lines before recovery, and keeping things fast and cool once you do get started.